All right, let's go, let's go, let's go. Hello, oh, wrong one. Hello. Hi there, my name is Brendan, and this is Action on Origin, your weekly writing web show, now appearing daily for this week only, which is almost over. Tomorrow is the last day of the stream week, drafting week in the drafting dungeon. So yeah, it's been a good week. We've been very productive, getting, most of, like, finishing the first draft of a 24-page comic, one shot, and, yeah, we're gonna be continuing that today, just moving forward with it. Yeah, tomorrow I have some ideas. Depends how long this takes, I wanna get this finished. So if I finish it today, then tomorrow we're going to do fun things and not serious things at all. But if I'm not finished, I'm going to work on this first. So yeah, be excited. Be very, very excited. Fun times going on. All right. Going back to the main screen now. So, let's... I don't know how to turn this coloring off. It was an accident. I'm sorry. Okay. So we are going to start with the character notes. And move on from there. See if I can change that real quick. I'll lock this one in place. Perfect. There we go. Fixed it. I figured it out. There was a weird thing there. And I have a copy of the draft to look along with you guys as we go. And actually, I'm going to throw the file up in my Discord as well. Fix that. Discord. Right. Delete. Cool. That is now up in the Discord if you want to take a look. Yeah, we're going to be editing today, Bode. We's going to be editing. I actually finished the first draft yesterday. So, yeah. I threw the file up in Discord if you want to follow along or give comments or feedback. Please do. Thank you. Okay. Mid-20s. Okay. We're gonna go film style here. Hey, what's up, Word? What's going on, man? We're gonna go film style. Bam. What's been going on, guys? Like, what are you up to? What are you doing? I don't think I need to explain that here. I still haven't figured out how I want to describe how I want to describe Shroud here. Like, I didn't really have a great image of him other than he has a weird English accent for some strange reason. Lender. Batman. Yes, indeed.
This is a Batman.
This shirt's actually really cool. I don't know if you can see it. It's got little bats making up the big bat. It's kind of sweet. It's also one of the few Batman shirts that isn't black. Which is also nice. It's not that the emotes aren't working, it's that there's a cap on how many you can use in one thing. I have no idea. I just turn Nightbot on and it just does its thing, I don't know. Also, let's fix this real quick. Oh, is that what's going on? I kept hearing people talk about Prime and I couldn't figure out what they were talking about. That makes so much sense though. Okay, you both should be good to spam emotes. Yeah, that's probably true, actually. Hey, Willow, what's going on? Is Twitch Prime really cool? I have no idea. I have not looked at it. I have no idea what it is. Oh, okay, I see what it is. Gotcha. The question is how expensive is Amazon Prime in Canada? That's my question. $80. I disagree about the lesser quality pizza, though I will say the best pizza I ever had was in Boston. I just don't think it's true across the board. Yeah, in the US, Prime is amazing. It used to be really expensive in Canada, though. It looks like it's dropped a lot. I'll look into it. I'll look into it. I need to figure it out, because I actually am sub to 3 streamers. I think I subbed to 4 actually. Yeah, I'm subbed to 4, but I'm probably gonna drop one. Harsh, bro. Harsh. Don't you live in LA? Aren't you on the complete opposite side from all the good pizza places in the States? Ah, gotcha. Fair enough, fair enough. I heard, well, I have friends living in New York, and, they like New York pizza, but it's very thin pizza. I'm not sure how I feel about thin pizza. Yeah, see, that's exactly what I just said. Bam. And Canadian pizza's all like that. So what if? Let me double check something real quick here. Okay, not helpful. Damn word, that's so far. Okay. So, that's the first page is finished. Yay. We've made progress. Only 27 more pages to go. Yeah, I like pizza so much that I literally don't care how good it is. I will just eat it. I'm gonna change the verb here. Boston Pizza is pretty good, actually. I like Boston Pizza. It's not my favorite pizza around here, but it's chain. Where haven't you lived, Bode? Lived. Because technically speaking, I've only lived in three cities. But I've been a lot of places. I'm willing to go out on a limb and saying we should always be talking about pizza. Yeah, I can afford my own pizza. Johnny can't. You should send Johnny pizza. I might order pizza today, guys. That might happen. I'm really feeling it right now. Is it clear here in panel two, this panel, that he's receiving payment? Like, will we understand the image? I always order pizza on my own. Because then you can eat the leftovers tomorrow. Right word, but I'm not American. As Bode keeps reminding me. I'm just kidding, buddy. I actually appreciate it. It's good. It's really funny. I'll come back to that panel. I think it's okay. But this panel three, I want to improve the description here. There's a lot of unnecessary stuff. Oh, Jesus, bro. I just assume that his wife has a job that requires a lot of travel. That is very fair. I don't know, I could be wrong. It could be you with the job that involves a lot of travel, but I thought you were writing full time. I could be wrong. I could be wrong. I only met you like 2 weeks ago. So, yeah, it was you? Okay. Gotcha. So he joined the circus. Bam. Man, if you were actually in the circus, I'd be so impressed. Like, they joke, but that's so legit. Well, see, I'm Canadian, so when I talk about circuses, I talk about Cirque du Soleil, the Canadian circus, which is actually unbelievably cool. But yeah. That might be just me. You're being for real? You're actually in the circus? Oh, cool, man. That's awesome. That explains Montreal and all that. Yeah, I figured that's, Well, Willow, if you ever want to go, if you ever want to go to the circus, go to Cirque du Soleil, because it is fantastic. I love Cirque du Soleil, but you know. I haven't seen a ton of their shows, but I think I still own the Canadian government some taxes. Probably. You probably do. That's crazy, man. What did you do with them? If you don't mind me asking you. Yeah, well, I know a lot about the touring industry, and I know how tough that is just in general. I have a friend who actually worked for, who used to work for Disney on Ice, touring with them. Sure, Johnny, but Cirque du Soleil is not an animal circus. They have a few shows that have animals, but it was, in general, they don't really do animal stuff. They're all about, like, acrobatics. Yeah, it's pretty bad. It's pretty bad, man. I'm not gonna lie, when I saw I was an acrobatic rigger, I originally saw it as I was an acrobatic tiger, and I was like, damn, bro, that's so cool. That sounds super legit. They only do like a couple of shows with animals, so I feel like they would take a lot of stuff into account when they were doing them. You know, I'm not an expert on these things. Yeah, totally. Oh, totally. The amount of safety precautions and like cues and stuff, like I could see that being a stressful job. As is any performance style job. Like, they're stressful. You can't mess up because it ruins the show. Oh no, they don't do safety nets in Cirque. Official, I put my stamp on it. I'm gonna change this. I don't think this needs to be from the side. It doesn't really matter. Damn, bro. That's impressive. That is very impressive. Alright. Page 2 is done. Actually, page 3 is done as well. Yeah, I hear you, bro. I hear you. If you can write a book every other month, that's incredibly impressive. Good point. That's a good point. Oh, first thing, I gotta fill in this Hawker's dialogue here. I have a couple of opinions on that. The first is, it depends why you're writing. If you're writing to make money, you're in the wrong business. That being said, if you're writing for other things, sometimes not getting paid doesn't matter. Sometimes you need to do all that writing so that you can get to a stage where someone will buy your work. Also, I am sure that you could use them as young as 5 to market stuff for you. Yeah, no, and that's kind of what I mean, man. Like, I totally get that. Like, I'm not saying we shouldn't be paid or anything like that. I'm just saying that because I don't make any money writing, and I would like to eventually. But exposure is important. Exposure is important. Streaming on Twitch is going to improve your market 100%. Because there are people across the world, such as me, Robin, who you're talking to there, who wants to edit your work real bad. Like, this is like the third or fourth time she's asked in the last couple days. But yeah, like, we're people you never would have met in real life, probably. So you've already started growing your reach and your market of, like, people. And that's partially why I stream too. Like, it's for me to work on my skills. I don't work on, like, my personal projects on stream. I work on stream projects on stream. And this is not something I've necessarily talked about specifically live yet, but the reason I do that is because I want the sort of stream stuff to be self-enclosed. I want it to be stuff that I can give away, stuff that I can show, stuff that I can use as learning experiences. Like, I'm not doing it to publish this stuff. The stuff I want to publish, I do on my own time. On time that I use, like, for freelancing and things like that. And, yeah, I would love to get a link to your website as well, Vote, if that's cool. I will check it out. Not right now. I will check it out later. But, yeah, like, I'm of the opinion that, like, the stuff on here is stuff I want to give this stuff away. I'd like to have stuff to show, like building a sort of portfolio in a certain sense, and then have my own stuff to get paid for, separate, different, you know? Oh, sorry. I will get... I have two mods here. Someone link that. Someone get that. Actually, I can just... Got it. Thank you. Oh, man. That cover design is super cool. Hells yeah. I'm very impressed by that. All right. Yeah, no problem, man. Do that. I got the link, though. All good. I should probably just do, like, label the hawkers and just do them separate. Probably easier. Hawker 1. Hawker 2. Yeah, that one. I really like that cover design. Like, that image that you have on the main page is just super, super legit. Oh, yeah, we're cool, man. I'll take a look at it, for sure. See? Look, you've already got more exposure. I haven't read a book in a while, to be honest. I've read a shit ton of graphic novels, but I've not read an actual book. It's just my fault. There hasn't been anything I really wanted to get into. Fair enough. Dr. Apocalypse. That reminds me of... every time I hear a name like that, I'm reminded of one of my favorite Warren Ellis comics, which makes no sense and is a terrible read, but it's kind of amazing. It's called Dr. Sleepless. I think it's Warren Ellis. Yeah, it is Warren Ellis. Check this out. Dr. Sleepless. It's all about weird future transhumanist strangeness. Yeah, that's an Avatar press book, and I don't know if anyone knows Avatar. I don't even know if I can show this on stream, because it's probably... So Avatar Press is like this really weird indie comic publisher. They work a lot with Warren Ellis, but some other people as well. Okay, it's not too bad. We can survive. But they're all about weird graphic violence and like very odd... stories. Oh, nips. My bad. There's a strange publisher. They do publish this really awesome, or they used to. I don't know if it's over or not. They used to publish a really awesome. God, why is Firefox doing this to me? It's been doing this all week. It's so frustrating. It's not working properly. They were publishing an awesome webcomic written by Warren Ellis called Something Angels. Freak Angels. I'm pretty sure it's called Freak Angels. Is that on here? God, what the hell? I don't know why Firefox is doing this, but it's crazy. Anyway. So I need Chrome. Now we're good. Yes. Freak Angels was originally published by Avatar. I don't know if they still are. They still have the logo there, so I'm assuming they are. But yeah, big fan of this. It's pretty cool. Looks like they haven't updated it in a long time, though. Oh no, they finished. It's over. Cool. Dr. Apocalypse is on Kindle. I see it right here in front of me. How many hawkers should I write? That's a very good question, Robin. I don't think there's a good answer. Change this. Shot of Pharaon from behind. Still standing in the hallway, flipping up the hood on his cloak. The door is now open and sunlight streams in. Perfect. Note, Pharaon is disguised as a guard. I think that's okay. Passing guards transporting richly dressed bodies. Ugh, I'm gonna change this. Transporting the bodies of dead royals. This says covered by clothes. Well, sure, Johnny, but I can't get away from an active chat. I can actively turn off music. Which, could you imagine if I was active chat plus music? Like, how bad that would be? Sure, man. Have a good one. Yeah, I can't see being that being a big thing. To be honest. Or maybe that's just me. Maybe I'm just way more familiar with the internet. Challenge yourself, find out. I don't think you'd enjoy that very much. I'm not going to. That's not going to happen. I actively invite you, if you want to listen, if you want music that you can play your own, man. Play whatever you like. I get way too distracted. I think that's better. Why shot a Pharaon outside a small door set. Taking off the guards that's costing them. He's wearing underneath. The moat. Would it be a moat or a river? Ah, I'll say moat. Moat's fine. Sploosh. I feel like I'm missing a panel here. I feel like there should be something else happening. Okay, so I'm gonna take a 5 minute break. And then we'll come back and we'll work on this page. Break time. He is break time. It just kind of happened, Ronnie. It just kind of happened.
Before I sing so sweetly, feel my legs give out from beneath. tasted so lovely. Golden lips 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 tasted so lovely. Golden lips.
All right, here we go. I'm back. Seabode, instant exposure. That's all I'm saying. This is why we do what we do. Oh yeah, and for the record, that's my friend's band, Onion Face. They are really, really, really good. I've seen them play in a bunch of different cities. They are fantastic. And doing some good stuff. I'm hoping their album will be released soon, and they'll have a lot more stuff available online. But yeah, they also gave me my first paid writing job. I wrote their bio for some stuff, which is really cool. Yeah, I linked the thing already for you, Robin. Yo, remember when I stayed at your house and went to see a band? This was the band I went and saw. By the way. The other thing that's interesting right now is, why do I have such a fascination with having people walk through doors in my stories? I don't know why that's always a thing. Dude, what? Yeah, see, there you go. No, I think I need to do the panel of the, Oh, you know what? The other thing I could do is I could add a panel here. Whoa. That song was Golden Lips. Their single from their album. Right.
Let's split this up a bit.
It'll be all right, man. It'll be all right. Okay, we're good. So we're gonna update this to 4 panels. I think that's better. I think that is a little bit better of a sequence. I felt weird with the 3 panels. I also don't super love 3 panel pages, to be honest. I think it should generally be 4 to 6. And if it's not 4 to 6, it should be 9. But that's just because I'm an Alan Moore guy. I don't actually own a copy of From Hell, do I? No, I don't. I've read it like 6 times. But I don't actually own a copy. The problem with 8 page panels is that, well, I'm actually kind of joking. That's not stuff I take super serious in this draft, because I'm not doing layouts and stuff. Usually, when I write comics, I am a hardcore layout guy. Like, hardcore layout guy. But I'm very much influenced by Alan Moore and Jeff Lemire and those guys, and like Alan Moore especially uses like heavy grids. Like if he has 9 panels, it's three groups of 3 in a grid. If he has 8 panels, it's 2 groups of 4 in a grid. You know, that kind of thing. Which I really like. Me and Stevie Ray Drawn have had conversations about this in the last while, because she hates that. She hates grids so much. And I love them, and it just, we, anyway, we're good friends, we get along very well, except specifically when it comes to comics and comic layouts. we just don't mesh on comic stuff. But hey, that's the way it goes sometimes. Yeah, I need to split some of these up. Just because the sentence structure looks hella odd. I don't want to be a naysayer, Robin, but technically your degree is in screenwriting and not, like, creative writing. So, yeah. Just saying. Oh, wait, did you finish that minor? Did you do a minor? Am I crazy? I don't have any degrees, so, you know, it is what it is. I don't think it's a make or break thing. What did you minor in, though? Did you minor in creative writing? Was that what you minored in? Or do you minor in something else? I forget. You don't have to tell me. Yeah, fair enough. I just remember talking about it and I couldn't remember like exactly what happened. I know kind of what you mean though. Like, I used to be able to spell really well. I think it's just I don't take enough time to do it. Like, I write too quickly. Okay. That page is done. Cool. Sure, but then your literal. I understand that, but at the same time, your literal next message was how mad you were that you can't spell when you can just edit more. I don't know. Whatever. That's true, I do know that. So I'm gonna get crucified, but I've never seen Game of Thrones or read Game of Thrones, and I have no wish to, really. So, yeah, I kind of know what you're talking about, sort of. Not really. I know his character.
Let's add some E's here. Making progress, guys. Making progress. Page 8 of 28. Let's go. Let us go. I'm not sure that Farron would be able to crouch. Or that he would be able to actually help him up. I don't think he could actually do that. I should probably show you what I'm talking about. That would help. That would definitely help. I hope that's a good wahaha, Robin. I'll be very sad at you. How do I describe what I'm doing right now? Let's add another like oh god, it started, Boat. I hope you're ready. She's never gonna leave you alone.
I think so. I think she is. I have no idea. Shit. I feel ya. Nothing else. Robin is a great editor. Kappa. She's awesome in general. Which is why she hangs out with us. This I saw line makes no sense. Because it kind of sounds like he's, when they brought us in, I saw this house. That's not really. That's better. Am I struggling? I don't really feel like I'm struggling, to be honest. This is my edit face. I'm just thinking, to be honest. What sound? You mean the sound effect I put in the comic? The one that I literally wrote as I said it? This one? I went, oh, and like wrote it? Or was there another one? Pretty much my life. I'm confused because I don't remember struggling. And usually when I'm struggling, I admit that I'm struggling. I feel like that's a thing that I do. I could be wrong. Change this to grab.
Good.
Do I want it to be click? I don't want it to be click. Also, I have way too many clicks in this comic. Too many clicks and creaks. Is there a better sound? Just feels bad. My bad. I thought you were making this emote, Johnny. Where is it? Come on. Or do I have too many clicks? Yeah, I have too many clicks. Need like a... Like what sound does metal make when it opens? Sound effects time.
SoundSnap.com. 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 SoundSnap. SoundSnap.com. 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 SoundSnap.com.
Interesting.
SoundSnap.com.
I have no idea. I don't know. Sorry.
Pond 5. Pond...
I want like a pop sound, but I think pop is too poppy. Does that make sense? Does that make any sense? Is my thought process at all clear? Chink? You think? Like, we're talking specifically about it opening, right? Now y'all are just quoting random sound effects happening. Apparently there's an interesting book called The Sound of Shackles. I'm just trying to figure out, like, a chink would be a sharp ringing sound, like, which would be more, like, sounds to me more like a hammer. What about, like, a clack? Or a clank? How about a clank? I could do a clank. All right, Johnny. I'll see you in a bit. Clack is good. I could go clack. Clack might be all right. Ooh, what about a schlick? I have heard Robin have that conversation with her fiance before. It's hilarious, by the way. I kind of like the schlick. That's an odd sounding sentence. All right, we're going with schlick because that's what I like right now. It's actually not that far off from click. Yeah, but shackles aren't the same thing as handcuffs, Robin. Fortunately. We're going with the schlick. I'm gonna say standing up. He grins. I don't like the bow. We're just gonna say gestures towards the door. better. You're a mod because with great power comes great responsibility. That's why you're a mod. It's more like 90%. But, you know, whatever. I'm pretty sure only I can ban you. And I feel like not banning you is a much better punishment. Nice. That's another page done. All right. We're on page 12 of 28. Nearly halfway there, guys. Nearly halfway there. We're a little over halfway in the stream, so hopefully the other pages won't take as long. I spent a lot of time on that sound effect, not gonna lie. This part. Through the dungeon, and then say this part is significantly darker than the previous section of the dungeon. What's another word for dungeon? But if I stream longer, that breaks my format. Interesting. I should call it a Bastille. That's what I should call it. I have a format? Sort of. And by format, I mean, like, I stream for 3 hours, I take two breaks, you know, stuff like that. Bastille description is probably terrible, but whatever. So my question is, if they're moving and then we see these guards, like, what is this image here of Pharaon turning? Like, what? What about that? Did she? She'll be back. Don't you worry. Not super liking this page right now. I find it a little confusing. Like, I don't feel these characters act like these characters. And really, it's just the distraction. I actually don't mind the rest of it. I just think panel 3 and panel 4, like, this stuff here just doesn't work. And I'm wondering if I should maybe just cut them and then write like a panel where the guards notice them and things happen, you know? Let me think about that. I will come back to it. Because, like, I like this panel, I like this panel, I like the first two panels, just this middle part that I don't like. So page 13 is done, but not page 12.
gonna remove the there. I don't think it's necessary. Between, again, no the. Between two torches. Aha. I'm gonna change this to a should be this one. I didn't like the aha, it sounded a little too comedic. Excellent, excellent. I love this rumble. Things on here. There we go. That's a great sound effect. My letterer will hate me if I ever get one. Am I better than that, Robin? Just talking chat. Come on. What's wrong with the hidden brick switch? I like the hidden brick switch. They're in a dungeon. Also, I have a vast precedent of having hidden passages in this comic already. So I kind of just like it. I kind of just like having more of them. I kind of feel like that'll just be a thing. There's just always a hidden passage. Like, almost like a weird in-joke of there's always a hidden passage. And there's going to be one time that there's not, and they're just not going to believe it, because... No, because there's no libraries. Hello. What's going on? Uh-oh. dashboard. My bad.
You're confusing people. I'm going to change this to a witch. Looks like it has been used in years. And say Shroud grabbed a torch from somewhere. Bam. Cool. Okay, we're good. That page worked really well. So 14's done, 15's done. Oh, the tunnels at York aren't so bad. You should see the tunnels at Carlton. Those things are insane. You can literally get from any building to any other building in Carlton without having to go outside. Yeah, so I only want to add disguised with a D. Cool. All right, so that's page 16 done. I'm gonna take another 5 minute break because it's about that time. So yeah, I will see you all in a few minutes. We'll be right back. Alright, I am back. I think that was only like 4 minutes, but whatever. I don't care. Good enough. Good enough. Hey, Wordman, what's going on, man? Yeah, we got about an hour to go. So, an hour to go, and approximately page 16 to 28, so 13 pages, give or take. So what's the math on that, guys? So I have to write a page. I have to do a page every 5 minutes. Those articles are hitting you hard, eh, Bone? Just need entertainment. I believe he's 36. Bam, look at me go doing the math. Nineteen years. Well, actually, probably a little longer than that. So yeah, 19. Yeah. I still feel like it's weird that I dropped the whole narration angle I had at the beginning of the thing. If anyone has suggestions where I should add some, please let me know. I'm not sold on it yet. Ferrara's outside the stable now. He looks around, checking for her. Yeah, okay, that's fine. One semester of poetry is always a bad idea. No, that's not true. Poetry is really cool. I just am terrible at it. Absolutely awful. Oh damn, that's like super legit though. Getting cited on Wikipedia. Only if the citation is by someone not you. By the way, I'm gonna qualify that. It has to be somebody else, and you can't ask them to do it. It just has to be done. Self-pity party. What's up, Office Man, by the way? One last check. I'm going to remove the creak. I don't think this one needs to creak. I think the rusty jail cell should creak, and I think a few other things should creak, but not this guy. This guy should be fine. Was that the one about Jesus Christ being in love with an immortal vampire? Or is that a different one? A gay immortal vampire, by the way. Just in case you were wondering how that went. Oh. Okay. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of like a skill in and of itself. Wow, it's actually got a Wikipedia entry. Jesus. Sometimes that happens, man. Sometimes that happens. Okay. I'm okay with all this. I'm pretty sure Word Wins entire stream is inappropriate for Twitch, but it's still fun. I don't know. I don't know what the rules on that are, of like, how far can you go with writing on Twitch? God, why is there another creek? Plus, this one's probably well used, so it wouldn't. Oh, yeah? For what, though? Interesting. It is possible. That being said, personally, I wouldn't really write that kind of thing on Twitch. But, you know, that's just me. I don't think it's typically inappropriate. I just wouldn't take the chance. But I mean, I think about it a little differently, right? Because I like, it's like I work on Twitch things on Twitch, and then I work on my own things outside of Twitch. And I feel like if I was going to write a sex scene, it would probably be in one of my own things and not in a Twitch thing. Just because the types of projects I do on Twitch are just different. Not drastically different, but a little different. Stylistically, they're a little different. They're a little simpler. A little less high-end, academic, deep and dark, either. I'm pretty okay with this page. Say that. 21 is done. Remind me that I need to go back to page 12, by the way, if I forget. I shouldn't forget, but I might. So I gotta figure out what I'm doing with that one panel. I'm gonna say something different here. I don't like the hold them down thing. Was Smish banned? Oh, okay. It was like I forgot what they call it. Yeah, like it's like they give you a couple warnings, right? Especially if it's not super bad, it depends what it is. Yeah, totally. If it's borderline, like, or an accident, they tend to not be too terrible about it, but it depends. I'm not going to get into that stuff, though. Like, again, you know, maybe I play it too safe, but it's more just, why take the chance? Why insult why insult the thing that you're literally using, right? It's weird. I'm going to take out this continue because I don't think it's necessary. I think that's all. No, that sounds about right to me. I don't think it necessarily has to be a month. I think they can do multiple weeks. Like, I think there's a 2-week ban. But whatever. I'm not going to get banned. So, mostly because I shouldn't be doing anything that would get me banned. Too shy, they're talking. What are we gonna do now? Even got the Bernard safe house, and we need to get out of the city for a while. Hello, Sully, by the way. Think there should be anybody. I don't understand this line. How are we There we go. That's better. I think that's better. Alright, that's 22 and 23 done. Oh yeah, Sully? What's it about? And don't make me regret asking that. Please. Sounds good, man. Sounds good. So are you collaborating with a group of people then? I want to put a caption here. And I know I probably don't need it, but whatever. Nah, I don't need it. It's so obvious. That's not cool. I don't do a lot of collaboration stuff.
I should do more of it. I think it'd be better for me.
Because I'm really good at certain things, and I'm not as good at other things. And I feel like having someone who can complement that and sort of take the workload off would really be productive for me. I should really read Save the Cat at some point. I've generally been taught, like in class, the gist of it, and I own a copy. I've never actually sat down and read it though. I'm just gonna say the camera. Is that a weird thing to say? No, I think that's okay. I'm cool with that. across the street and duck inside a door. Watch out. Inside is a small garden with a fountain. Stand around waiting. A dozen. I'll say a dozen. Leave it like that for the moment. I think that's okay. By the Burlyman. Huh. I'm not sure how I feel about that dystopia angle. Well, and that's not because I think that it doesn't work. I have very strong feelings about what a dystopia is. And I feel like any sort of, like, power struggle to restore or destroy a dystopia is not really what a dystopian story is about. But it's possible that you mean something similar. I don't know. I'm gonna say, call on the moneylender, lounges on a divan. And I don't think the story could begin right after a dystopia was created, simply because they wouldn't be aware that it's a dystopia for several years, I would think. But I honestly don't think that you mean dystopia here. Yeah. See, that makes more sense. I don't think you mean dystopia. Like, a dystopia is a very specific thing. going to change this image. Hands the sack to one of the guards. We can change this description. There we go. That makes so much more sense. That page is done. Okay, I'm going to move this panel 4 to the next page because I don't think it goes there. I'm going to put another panel here that is con points. Better, much better. That page is done. I'm gonna skip page 24 until the end because it's gonna take the most time by far. Or sorry, page 27. I'm gonna do page 28. Wait, what? Do I have 25 pages? Did I miss something? Oh, I miscounted. I forgot that there was a 2-3 split. Oh shit. I have one page too many. But you know what? That's fine. That's totally fine. Because it removes... I can just delete page 24 and it's not a problem. I didn't like the idea of having a fight scene anyway. Really what it is it's kind of like a... get him! And then it fades to black. And then the scene comes up and we end up with page 24.
Wow, that's such an amateurish mistake to make.
Yeah, so I'm just going to delete this entire page because I don't think it needs to be there. Boom. That solves a problem. I'm gonna remove this. I'm gonna remove this entirely, and I'm gonna put it up here. I think that's better. I think it's more descriptive of what it is. Yeah. It's like, okay, sure, just cut the thing that I was gonna have to work on. No problem. It sucked anyway. Whatever. I think this is a caption moment there. Though. I think this should just be... Bam. That's a problem solved. So 28's done, 27's been cut, no problem. By the way, I was referencing, when I say like 28 and 27 and all that, I'm referencing the page count in this, not the actual like page count. So we have to go back and finish page 12, and then we're done. Then it's done. So I just need to figure out what panel I'm doing with that, this one here. So I'm cutting this because I don't like it. I will make a duplicate though, before I forget, just in case I need it. Just toss it over here. And then, oh God, what page was that? Page 12, which is inside the dungeon. Okay. And then I'm going to delete this because it doesn't need to be there. Now, what image should I have this? This is not page 12. I took the wrong page 12. Dropping things and stuff. There we are. Okay. So I have this sequence that I need to figure out. Oh, I'm so jealous. I'm starving. I need to get food. So, drawing my panel here to sort of figure out what I have and what I'm missing. They're moving quickly down the hallway. Then there's two guards. Chatting it up, looking at a thing. I think what I should do is I should have another shot here where a guard like looks up. And then they see the two, they see Shroud running at them. Like a guard POV looking at Shroud running towards them. And then the two sequences as I have them right now. Where it's kind of like I'll show you the diagram in a second, just so you can see it. Nice and big. It's my sketch. How I think it should be. I think it's a lot stronger. Because I didn't like that distraction sort of element of it. And it's kind of more fun to just have like... Yeah. Sort of add this. Yeah. Right, so what I want to do is same shot, one, and well, it may not be gallery material, I do think my thumbnails are super legit. Everything I do is legit. That's not true. That wasn't my fault. I booked it super in advance. It's not my fault. POV shot from guard 2. Shroud is running straight at them. I'm totally gonna do it. Is it too funny if I do this? What a question. Does it ruin the tone of the comic if I add this sort of like silly element? Sort of? I don't know. I wasn't sure how I felt about it. Other than the amount of ridiculous, like, trapdoors and secret passages there are. That's hilarious and very silly. There's so many of them. If I was to continue this as, like, a comic, like, if I wrote, like, an issue number 2... to follow this, or an issue number 1, like this was a prologue, I would just keep up with that. Like, it's so funny to me. In a super weird way, it makes no sense. But yeah, I think I'll leave it like that. I think it's alright. So there we go. I think that's it, guys. I think I just finished it. Like, for serious. I think that's it. Oh, I do need to add one thing. Here. Farron is nowhere to be seen. Done. Oh, man. That was super legit. I had a great time doing this week. I really wanted to write something that wasn't like a prose story. So I just prefer scripting so much. I really do. But prose is where all the markets are. I don't know. I'd like to do some prose. Like, I don't hate prose or anything. I actually do enjoy it, and it's good to do because it is challenging to me. It's because it's more challenging to me. But yeah. Okay. So I'm going to compile this. Do it up. That panda emote is amazing. By the way. Version 2. Close. Just gotta make sure that. Got it. Compile. Second draft. Bam. Done. Oh god. So much spam. Okay. Cool. So I have about 5 minutes left. Well, 10 minutes actually. So I have about 10 minutes. So I'm gonna open it up to the chat. If you have any questions, anything you want to talk about, anything you want to ask me about, you want my opinion on something, please ask me. Ask away. I will do that for a few minutes, and then I'll close out the show. Call it a day, man. I'm super happy with this week. It went real well. It went really well. And I will be posting all of the drafts and all that onto my website. I gotta work on that today. I'll be working on that today. I will be finishing up the stuff on the website. I've made a final decision over all the stuff that I wanted to lurk. Wanted to look like. I just need to finish moving everything over. Rewrite what? What? Oh. Robin wants to know if she should rewrite her Peter Pan prequel. No, because that's already been done. Recently. Sorry. Chocomoco. I was drafting a comic book. So I just finished that. I've been working on it all week. 3 hours a day for 6 days straight. Actually, seven? 7 days straight? Yeah, a straight week. Because I started on... I started it on Monday. I'm wrong. So 6 days straight, yeah. Which is pretty good in my opinion. I think that's decent. I do feel like I need to read more scripts, though. I need to read more comic book scripts. Start getting a feel for what other people are doing, how other people are doing it. Do that more. I gotta finish reading this guy. Read part of it. Brian Michael Bendis, Words Pictures. I also have Scott McCloud's book, Making Comics, and Alan Moore's essay on writing comics, and I have a lot of things on writing comics. Have anything else over there? I have the From Hell Companion, which is really cool. That's also on writing comics. Yeah. Oh, that sounds so cool, Word. Can you send me the name of that? I want to check it out. Yeah, Drani, I finished the rewrite, and I think it's done. I think I'm going to call it done. I don't think any additional time will really make it better. To be honest. Which is good. That's a good thing in a lot of ways. It's one of those things where you kind of have to learn when to cut the reins, when to know when perfectionism isn't enough. And I think right now for this guy, that's it. That's good. Any other time would just be like polishing things that probably don't need to be polished. So yeah, pretty happy. Okay, well if you do find it, let me know. You can post it in the Discord. I'm kind of into it. I like stuff like that though. Like I like weird manga-y strangeness like that. Another one that was really cool for things like multi-dimensionist was Osamu Tezuka's The Phoenix. Which I liked. That's a weird series to try and read, though. Because it's kind of like a bunch of standalones and then a series, but like, I don't know. It's kind of confusing. Yeah. You can see all my writing books in the corner there. Like underneath my my inbox there. Those are all like my writing books. Got Lego above me and then all my comic books. Oh, let me shift to the right here. Or the left. Go to the left. These are all my comic books. Like these are all manga. You can see all like my manga and stuff. And then those are all trade paperbacks and hardcovers of comics on the bottom two shelves. What about Tsubasa Chronicle? Is that something I should be reading? Is that what we're saying? I know of it. More than I've actually read it. I have not heard of that one, Ronnie. I'll check it out. I will check it out. So yeah, that's gonna be it for. Whoa, my hair got all weird. It just sticks up everywhere. Anyway. So yeah, that's gonna be it for me for today, guys. I had a blast. I had a blast this week. Tomorrow. I will be streaming tomorrow. Tomorrow will be the last day of this week. Going back to my once a week on Sunday streams. So yeah, I will be streaming tomorrow. I'm not sure what I'll be doing yet, but I'll try and do something fun and silly and one-shotty. maybe a prompt or something. Maybe I'll find a good prompt. Or not try and find one and just pick one and do it. Something like that. We'll see. I'll take suggestions. If you have any suggestions, you can leave them on Discord or send me a thing on Twitter or whatever. At Free Glab Mishaps. Other than that, yeah. My name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show. Just about done appearing daily for this week only. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. I really appreciate it. Had a blast. Got a lot of stuff done. So, yeah. Peace.